So, going through the action item list, actually last night I took a walk down.
Can you turn your microphones up so we can hear you?
Oh, okay.
So very good.
Put it up just a little bit. Yeah, that slider.
Oh, actually, that's a good idea.
Is that better?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, we'll try.
Well, that's too, almost too.
Yeah, we'll see how it works. So, you know, last night my wife and I walked on the, where the trail would be, coming from Oak Island, we came that direction and relative to the Phragmites, there was a lot of Phragmites along the berm. So that kind of needs to be addressed before it really starts to hit the lake. So just want others to know, so we have some institutional memory of trying to forget or something. The coliform, we're still, you know, we'll be having relying on the Michigan Health Department for testing. We have here is kind of an action item, the boat ramp parking area renovations. We really haven't heard of anything on that. Joe, is that something that the board has been discussing? The one time it seemed like it was imminent, now maybe it's a future item.
It's a future item right now.
Okay. Lake monitoring, I don't know when. Ice is out. I don't know when they're going to have you do the phosphorus yet.
And we're at 2 years ago, and they said, might want to get on Southern Michigan.
Yeah.
So, yeah, my boat's still set in the garage, but I told us.
We just need phosphorus or a chlorophyll tube. It's phosphorus. Okay. But, you know, probably we can do it via kayak.
I talked to JB, so I can get a truck or you can get a truck as a hitch.
Oh, okay.
But right now, the car doesn't have a hitch on it.
I didn't have a hitch.
Yeah.
So you got friends with hitches.
We have friends with hitches, and as soon as we can declare an infant a winner, because I don't want to go out there that much. This morning it was froze up.
Yeah, you could walk out. Well, no. The purple loose strife, we still have waving goose management. I've seen some of the geese seem to be starting to pair up and get on the muskrat huts, but it's a little early. So but by our March, by next meeting, they'll be probably looking swing. Hopefully, goose busters busts them up. And then the nature trail we'll discuss later. So, the future items don't really have to go through. Anything else? Any thoughts on action items? That was pretty small time. So we have Friends Park Lake report. Judy, do you want to update us?
Good evening, Judy Gardy. So nice to see you all. So first of all, I'm going to talk about a new priority for Friends of Park Lake, which is traffic calming. We had that hit and run 6 weeks ago, maybe a month ago, I can't remember. And then, of course, we had an accident which took part of my house down, you probably noticed. But traffic calming is going to be a priority of ours. We went to the Road Commission, and we've talked about several strategies with them. They are going to do a walking audit of Park Lake Road with us to determine whether or not, what kind of traffic calming strategies might be most effective. We've talked with them about signage. There isn't even a sign for the beach that says you're approaching a beach. We've talked to him about crosswalks, perhaps a crosswalk from the beach area to the township parking lot across the street from the creamery, and a crosswalk that will go from the boat launch to the park. The reason crosswalks are so important is that they are, when there's a pedestrian or non-motorized person vehicle in a crosswalk, you have to stop. It's the law. So that would really slow traffic down, especially when in the summer, when we have so many people down there. We've spoken to him about really looking at the road from where Meridian Township and Bath Township come together by the old sod farm there where the speed limit goes up to 55. That perhaps that should be lowered to 45 and that that might start to bring the speed down as people come into the community. And then the last thing we talked with him about was the possibility of doing center stakes that would be removable for winter in the center of the road. In many communities which are having similar problems to the ones that we experience on Park Lake Road, they have put stakes in the middle of the road. They're orange and white stakes, you know, that just remind people that they need to slow down. And the last thing that we spoke to the road commission about was the importance of enforcement. It's one thing to have the Bath Police Department present in the neighborhood. And it's another one to have them enforcing the speed limit in the neighborhood. And we have asked the road commission to look at the speed on the road. They're going to put up black boxes. I saw one today on Webster Road that are not like our computer-run speed boxes that we have at Park Lake Road right now. But they're different than that, and they will track your speed, so they are going to do a speed study on the road as well. And I've asked them to engage the Bath Police Department in this process with us. The reason we've gone to the county is I brought this to the attention of the township board at the beginning of 2022 when the car drove through my house. There was no action. I spoke to the township board about it. I spoke to the township road committee about it, and this is a county road. And we can't wait any longer. So I've gone to the county, we've gone to the county, and the county will participate in the process of doing a traffic calming study for Park Lake Road. In addition to that, Friends of Park Lake has purchased 30-yard signs, which will say, please slow down, Friends of Park Lake, which as soon as they're around delivered, we'll bring them to the neighborhood. We're doing two events this summer, a bike ride, which we did last year. This year, we've joined forces with a local bike club and Dalmac. We'll have a 10-mile ride, a 20-mile ride, and a 30-mile ride. These will be destination rides. The 10-mile ride, the destination is the Great Valley Long Necks Alpaca Farm on Howell Road. The 20-mile ride will go to the MSU Ecological Burn Banding Station at Quarry Marsh. They have another one, so it'll go into that ecological. There's 400 acres up there. And the 30-mile ride will go to Sleepy Hollow. Sleepy Hollow has bike trails within the park. And of the 104 bike trails evaluated by the state of Michigan last year, Sleepy Hollow's bike trails came in number 10. So we'll encourage them when they get up to Sleepy Hollow to take the longest one of those rides around the park. As I said, these are destination rides. These are riders, young riders, probably some older riders too, but these are young people who are preparing to ride from Lansing to the Mackinac Bridge. So they do these practice rides, and they like to have a destination, so it's not just a bike ride for 30 miles, but it's a destination ride. So that is happening on June 10th. The rides will begin at 10 o'clock at Wishwasher Park. Each ride will have a leader. There will be designation signs along the route so people will know what to do. But in addition to that, we're going to go to Dalmac and we're going to ask them for a grant. And the grant will put a post in the park at Wishwasher Park, which will be laminated, and it will have those three bike routes on that post so that any family at any time could come to Wishwasher Park and ride one of those rides and know exactly where, you know, where the destination was. We're also on June 21st having our summer solstice party. It will be from, we've decided we are having a summer solstice party every year. We might as well do it on the day. I don't care if it's a Wednesday. We're having our summer solstice party on summer solstice. So June 21st, from 5 to 10, we decided to just do in the evening because it's so hot during the day. We'll have a concert at 7 o'clock. The Dangling Particles will perform for probably an hour and a half. We've invited the Central Michigan Beekeepers Association, so they're really a phenomenal organization. They have a lot of educational materials about bees and harvesting honey, and they'll have bees and they'll have honey there and a lot of educational materials and activities. And we'll have a food truck down there called the Little Honey Pot. We'll have a balloon twister and a bounce house. The library will be down there. Dan, I hope, and the students will be down there. The Great Lakes Longneck Alpacas will be there as well, as a few other organizations from within town. I've invited the Public Art Committee, but they're just getting formulated. Our next Friends of Park Lake meeting is April 18th at the Community Center at 7 o'clock. So that's what we've been doing.
Lots of stuff.
Yeah.
And any questions for Judy?
Well, just also say that we've been working with the township on the trail. And our go-to person on the trail is Ray. He's got COVID right now, so he's not with us. But he's been on top of this with the drain commissioner and working on the easement issue. He understands the easement question that Karen has asked. He and I both have had long conversations with the drain commissioner about the trail. We're still working on that. John?
Just a recommendation about the crosswalks.
Yes.
So, besides what's painted on the road, you need a sign, if one is saying, stop for pedestrian and crosswalk, or something to that effect, because in Michigan, zebra crosswalks that aren't associated with the intersection, drivers aren't required to stop for pedestrians.
Unless there's a sign? Is that what you're saying?
Right.
Right, I'm sure we would include a sign so that people would have to stop. We're having great cooperation from the road commissioner. I spoke to him about the traffic calming project about 3 months ago, and then he said he promised it was before the new year that he would put it on his list of things to get to this year, and then I called him about a month ago, and he's really excited about it. It is on his list of things to do this year, so hopefully we will get some action on that. Any other questions?
No, I just wanted to let you know that it was on the evening of February 18th when the hit and run occurred.
February 18th what? I'm sorry?
When the hit and run occurred.
Oh, it was February 18th.
Yes.
The hit and run on my house was March 15th.
Does anybody know how the person is?
I haven't heard.
Thank you very much.
I heard it as well.
Initially, I don't know what's happened since then.
It keeps me to be.
Okay. So, good. Well, thank you, Judy.
Appreciate that.
Moving next on the township board, I don't know if you can update us a bit, Joe, on stuff relevant to our plate.
Yeah, I was at the recreation meeting, so that was kind of good. Monday night.
Can you talk into your mic, please, Joe?
Yes, sure.
Thank you.
I was at the recreation meeting on Monday night, and we discussed Wishwasher Park and some of the improvements that are scheduled for there. They're going to be doing some engineering on the drains in Wishwasher Park this year. It needs to be updated. They're also going to be taking a look at the parking lot, along with, we did a survey there. I think there were 5 lots involved in all of that property, and then the 6th piece will be Nichols Road. And so they're going through and dotting the I's and crossing the T's with all this survey work, so we're going to have one big piece of property on that side of the road instead of all of the lots. On the other side of the road, we made a land addition also, and those will be surveyed this year and also combined into the Record Boat Launch property. So that'll be one piece of property. Another thing that I thought was interesting is we're going to add some cameras down there. DPW is going to put some cameras over where the pavilion is, and they're also going to put a camera at the boat launch. So we're going to have some more eyes down there. And that's really what we discussed on Monday. And there'll be some improvements to the property there also. Especially on the new property that we got, and combining those lots, cleaning them all up and making them look nice. The community engagement is tentatively supposed to be part of the recreation grant, recreation study that they're going to do in the township along with the non-motorized trail has been pulled into that also. And so that's what they're planning on doing, the community engagement as to what we might do with this new property and the property across the street that's kind of under construction.
Do you know when the community engagement is? Have they figured that out yet?
They haven't scheduled it yet, but, you know, they're in the process of doing that.
And with that, then they will start to decide, like, basketball courts, what they're going to do.
It's a normal type of engagement. You make a
major suggestion.
Make a big list, and then you pare it down to what you can afford and what you can do. But the community's going to be involved in that process. So, at the township board, we did approve the road contracts at the last meeting, and the road committee has already gone to the county with those approved projects, so we can start to get some quotes back from them. And something kind of unusual happened. Because the price of oil is less this year, it looks like our costs are going to go down instead of up, which is, we're very used to things going up. We're not so used to saying, maybe we'll save you some money here. So we're in that process, and we'll see how that comes out. So we're pretty excited about the fact that it might cost less. So that's about it for me. Anybody got any questions?
One, I assume the cameras at the boat launch are just to capture mischievous stuff, not as a way to, we could use that to monitor people who are breaking the law by not washing their boats.
No, but I think I would like the camera, because they haven't told me what they're putting out there, and that's all I'm concerned. I would like it put so you could see who was launching and how many boats we launched, because we count those.
Yeah, at least that's
okay, and so that's kind of my goal. I'm not counting boat washers. I'm just very interested in how much we use the boat ramp.
Okay. Thank you.
And just highlight, because I had a camera, but it's not continuous with the game camera. The time to count is not trivial. And if you want to actually count boat launches, it's going to take some of the hours to go through the footage.
Well, I don't know what kind of camera we're going to get, but if we got one that you have to watch in real time on yours?
Well, mine, I had a game camera, so it only triggered when
something
But every time the guy goes down there and plays with his dog, every time somebody drives through, just driving through, it's
so you have to watch all of that to know.
Yep.
Okay.
Well, it's a lot of time. I mean, if it's a continuous record, you can play it in speed up mode, but it still takes a human effort and time.
Yeah, well, it's something we might want to look at.
And there are ways to more what we call self sampling to get estimates, right?
Maybe artificial intelligence will be able to do that very soon. Count it by itself without us having to look.
It actually probably could, but I mean, we do it with wildlife, but the training, it took a grad student 10 grand worth of time to figure out how to train it. So, you're going to spend money somewhere if that's a goal.
So, the goal is, Google has some recognition software, so
insurance photos they took just to see if it would work. And I just asked it how many boats are on each page, and it did a really good job.
Okay. We're just looking for an estimate, so that's good.
Identifying. But to automate it would have required some working with some APIs if that wasn't real familiar with it. So ended up not using that.
And I think the point of the data itself is valuable, understanding how much usage there is for a lot, just your planning, expansion, servicing, whatever. Yeah, that kind of planning data is valuable.
Good. So with that, I think next on the agenda was the water level report. Started it out there.
Yes, so they included the measurement. Okay, so January 16th of this year. So that's the first measurement we've seen. And the next one, it took a few days ago in March. And so there's a 6-inch difference there. When I checked with NOAA, we see 6.4 inches of rain in the period between January and March. So far it seems to be pretty much good precipitation.
It looks like it's pretty near. Near the spillway.
2022 was a bad year.
Yeah, we've recovered an awful lot. You looked at the end of 2022 and first in 2023. We've recovered a lot of that since. It's just, we're driven off by the rain.
Sure.
Okay. Good. Well, thank you. So the old business, actually, I'll probably do these out of order a little bit. I think everybody's had a chance to comment on the annual report. I think we're good. Jeannie actually sent me some additional photos. Let me see if I can incorporate those. Those were fun to
do. The fun was a little great.
Yeah, I think, it helps spice it up. So since we have Marie here, we'll just let you know we'll be sending our approved annual report to you and the board soon.
You want to come and present to the board and make sure you...
I think that would be good. I think that just maintains a dialogue with the whole board rather than that. The timing, we'll have to watch the timing if I recall what makes it available.
Okay. Thank you.
I'll CC you all as I send it. Change just so you all have again the final copy. Lots of good stuff in there, so I don't regret it. I didn't get to the vote counting this year. You're tired of that. Dawn's done it, John. It takes a bit of time and brain power. So
I know because I mentioned it.
Well, thanks. So the nature trail update, I think I sent to you all forwarded an email from Karen. So again, I guess the way to put it, it's still creeping along. However, the memo she sent along here is basically kind of potential next step is getting Drain Commissioner Phil Hanses to do an easement that would allow kind of the public access at kind of the point of the water control structure, I imagine. Rather than having to fuss with the landowners at the south end of Webster's access and all that's entailed. So I think that's all the update I have. I think we chatted last time. I did express concern to Karen that we feel like we're not being kept in the communication loop well, so I keep expressing that if that continues now. Once we're in the loop, we'd like to stay in the loop, I guess that's the way to put it. So I think Judy mentioned Ray, hopefully he recovers well from COVID. That could be a tough thing. So again, we'll just keep tabs on that. Any insights? Or if there was one other thing I thought. John mentioned the link Karen sent to us actually linked to a different meeting, I think.
And I looked at the meetings and I couldn't find it.
You couldn't find that one. So I'll make a note. I'll check with Karen to see, if actual link for that special meeting.
Get them to different people. I tried to look at it too. I spent a lot of time looking at different meetings that I never saw it, so.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah. Yeah, we'll see if we can get that again. But I did, I don't know if you were all in on the CC. You know, she encouraged us to look at it, and some people, like Mary, were actually there and still came away confused. And that was what I tried to articulate to Karen, that watching it, being there didn't clarify. Watching it isn't necessarily going to clarify things, yeah. where we are. I mean, so.
And also, I spent much of the morning watching meetings out of that system. The ability to hear what's being said is really limited.
Is it limited? So it probably depends, like us, where you are.
Right.
It depends on the mic. So.
I've watched that meeting twice now. I watched it live and then I rewatched it. And I was really surprised at how good the audio was. I could hear everybody actually talking in their chairs. So get ready for that.
It's probably all or nothing.
But we are sitting in the new system right now. And I know that the audio at my home is wonderful with the live meetings. So things are much improved. And that was one thing that many of the board members wanted to do, was update this group.
I watched the, and I think it was January 21st, board meeting. And in order to help, I put my earbuds in. And somewhere near the beginning of the meeting, somebody accidentally hit their microphone and just about blew the earplugs right out of my head. Thank you very much.
Just making sure people are awake when they're sorry. Do that to students. So, remind you to turn on your hearing aids. And just, it's a reminder. So, all right. Well, so I think with the nature trail, it's kind of sit tight, but again, I will express, you know, it's good to be kind of getting back into the information loop. It's kind of, it's been somewhat off on that. New business, I really didn't have any. I don't think we have much. It's getting to where the lake is waking up, although I went back to sleep a little last night. There's been a ton of whistling swans or tundra swans, depending on what you like. A lot of diving ducks. I've seen more golden eyes this year than I've seen.
I 2 weeks ago, I managed to watch the golden eye do their little dance out there.
Yeah.
Which are pretty interesting.
Right now, they're still doing their displays.
It would be, yeah. And yesterday morning, there was a small block of bald people from the house.
Oh, okay, cool. Which other name is Legion?
American Legion.
Are the whistling swans welcome?
Yeah, those are native swans. They will be, I'd have to check what you name, but the tundra swan, whistling swan, they nest way up in the high Arctic, and they're native. So they won't be nesting here, whereas the trumpeter swans will nest in this area. But I haven't seen any nesting on Park Lake yet. It's possible I've seen them at Corey Marsh, because Judy mentioned that I've seen them. It's Half Moon Lake. There was a nesting pair that brought off this summer I saw. So those of the trumpeters were seriously threatened or endangered. They're making creeping inroads back. So.
Yeah, it was nice to see them.
Yeah. Yeah, these are huge groups. I don't know how
we have never seen that many of them hanging around for that length.
Yeah, usually you have in the past, and Donna and I've seen. I think it was one year they had like 200 sitting on the ice for a day and then they're gone.
Yeah.
This year they've been, I think it's probably because the ice, I don't think it's out much further north. So
there's some catching bird around the lakes.
Yeah, so these birds are just the weird weather we have. They're taking advantage of it. That's the point. That's great. That and the red-winged blackbirds are back in force.
So, a couple of vehicles just showed this way too.
Okay, so thanks for coming back. So, with no new business, any public comments? like spectators, which is okay. We like spectation.
May I?
Yeah, well, yeah, of course.
The nature trail, I haven't been tuning in as much as I have in the past, but every now and then it just doesn't take much to get up to speed. And it appears that things are not moving very quickly. And is that mostly a funding issue? I guess that's my question.
No. To my understanding, it's mainly been kind of the easement access model, is the best way to put it. We, township, had that property resurveyed, and even with the resurveying, there is still contention by the adjacent property owners about easements and that. So, and that's partly where this memo, if the drain commissioner does allow easement, that forestalls a lot of that potential problem. So, that's my understanding.
To get from Webster Road to the township property on the other side of the dam, will the trail go right over the dam, or have you got enough room to get around the edge? The edge of the dam as Ken Jeremy's property.
It's still to be determined. The detail of how to get, across the
he'll provide an easement across a land bridge. So we will not go across the dam. The water control structure, where the water flows.
Yeah.
He'll provide an easement across the land bridge just beyond there.
He being Ken?
The township, the county.
So again, these are those fine details. We could have a path that goes across where the dam is. We just have that boardwalk extend overhead. But
it sounded like he didn't want to do that, wasn't it?
He's very willing to do that.
Oh, he is?
He's very willing to do that. His hesitation is the township's inability to make a decision about whether or not they want that trail. And he will not move until the township board votes to support that trail.
So when is the board, Joe, when's the board going to vote?
Well, it's the first I heard that one, but I'll give you another one.
Okay.
If we do have the easements that Judy's describing, how are we going to provide emergency services to the trail? We'd have to be able to get an ambulance back there. In case somebody has a heart attack or breaks a leg, or just this is just normal procedures.
I would question that, because when you go to Lake Lansing, where they have a big nature trail, there's no way to get an ambulance back in there.
We're not going to get an ambulance back in the trail itself. But we have to get our personnel there. So that's all under kind of being looked at. Like, if we do the trail, how are we going to provide emergency services to the trail?
So I will comment as the chair. That's the first I've heard of that particular issue, which this board's role is to advise. Unless we're told of issues, we can't give advice.
The communication has been off.
That's been my frustration.
Looking at, if we get this done, which is wonderful, and I support that, I've only voted for it 4 or 5 times now, then how are we going to get emergency services to those people if something happens? We have other equipment, but we have to start looking forward. Otherwise, we're just going to get slowed down if we don't start looking forward.
Again, I will reemphasize. The we means us too, because we are an advisory board that has been involved since day one.
So put your thinking caps on, because I'd be really interested.
What I want to say is we need to have that communication come from the board to us. And I want it in writing so we have a record, because that's the only way, it's my experience with institutional memory. You told me that, and that's good. That's good communication, but it isn't from the board, it's from you as an individual. That's what we need, is clarity, because otherwise we get in these, I heard this, I heard that. I respectfully request things in writing to keep the documents, because then 5 years from now, when a different set of members are here, if there's no writing, they don't know what the hell happened.
Okay.
I
respect that. I'll refer to Karen and see how she wants to
do that. No, I think, because again, in our memo we wrote to Karen and the board, we
clearly articulated we wanted to know any impediments to the future. And we haven't heard him back except for what you just said. So that's where I am very frustrated that there are impediments you're identifying. You, the board, is identified, but not related back to us.
I always understand this.
Whatever they mean, I understand. I never speak for the Bath Township Board.
No.
I do not.
Okay.
I'm here as an individual board member. I'm sharing with you what I see.
Yeah.
And now I'll go back and say, how do you want to manage this work?
Right.
That would be
okay.
That's what I would get. And I'm going to do one other thing for you. I'm going to ask for a list of impediments that they all see. Okay. As something that we're going to be working on in the future.
That's exactly what we've already
asked. What I've been a little bit uncomfortable with is kind of doing this, the direction that we're doing it. So maybe we can get some of it possible.
What's your last statement? What do you mean by you're uncomfortable with it? What direction? I'm not sure.
It's going a little slower than I would like.
Okay. Okay.
So I get a little bit frustrated with the speed that things are going, but again, I do watch that meeting live that you were at, and I watched it in its entirety again. And there's a lot of good points that were brought up there, and a lot of people got their questions answered by the players that are involved in this, the property owners, the drain commissioner, the county road commission was there, the county road commission's attorneys were on fire giving the answers to people. Sometimes they answer the same questions three times. It was a regular meeting. So if you get a chance to get a hold of that.
I was there as well.
So. Yeah. I know it's going to be over 2 hours. It was a long meeting, but there's a lot of information there.
So, okay. Question.
And I will convey your concerns to the administration and board that you would like a list of impediments to the trail at this point in time, what everybody sees. Because other people are also very involved in this. We have a lot of staff involved in this. So we need to know what they all see.
Okay. John,
I have a question. In the email Karen sent to Dan, she said, at the next meeting of the board, the drain commissioner has been invited to discuss an easement across the property.
Yeah, she said he's coming to the next meeting.
Okay. Wasn't sure. This was a past tense or...
He's going to the next board meeting.
Right. There'll be an agenda posted on that meeting on Friday this week. Look to see if he's on there, because he might not have been available. This is like everything else.
So go back to that Rick he brought. Does this answer your question?
Yes. I just threw it out on the table. You know, there's another expression, throwing something on the table. And I guess I did that, but it sparked the kind of conversation I was hoping to hear. So, thank you.
Good. Thank you. So with that, I think any other comments for everyone? So with that, we are adjourned, and we will meet again next baseball group.
I can't see that anything happening up there. It might be so much harder.